Hi everybody, my name is Markus Mottl and I'm going to present to you AD-OCaml. This novel framework for algorithmic differentiation and implicit parallelism offers a wealth of features that is often missing from existing solutions. So what is algorithmic differentiation? It's basically about turning a computer program provided by the user into another program that augments it with mathematical derivatives. Due to the nature of some of these transformations, this may possibly also improve the program's efficiency or introduce parallelism. This is depicted in the computational graph below, which was automatically generated from the given user program, turning a simple feed-forward neural network into an implicitly parallelized backpropagation network. Unlike solutions that use numerical approximations, algorithmic differentiation yields mathematically accurate results for gradients and directional derivatives. AD methods are also typically more efficient. Obtaining derivatives using AD only takes a constant factor more time than evaluating the user program. One restriction is that the computer program is differentiable. It may seem surprising, but this is frequently already the case or can often be achieved with minor changes or relaxations. The application areas of AD obviously cover many scientific disciplines where parameter optimization or sensitivity analysis are important. AD also generalizes previously discovered computational techniques. For example, the famous backpropagation algorithm in machine learning is just a special case of reverse mode algorithmic differentiation applied to feed-forward neural networks. AD should not be confused with other methods. Unlike symbolic differentiation, which can lead to intractably large terms, AD should rather be seen as an exact numerical method. But we can still combine it with symbolic program optimizations when convenient. Unlike numerical differentiation, sometimes called bumping, it does not introduce approximations, which in practice can lead to substantially incorrect results. So finally, how can we make algorithmic differentiation work with a sophisticated language like OCaml? The approach used by AD-OCaml is the so-called tagless final style. What do we mean by that? Most OCaml applications represent programs using algebraic data types as a so-called initial representation. These terms can then be evaluated or transformed using pattern matching in various interpreter functions. Some implementations tag terms with type information that needs to be checked at runtime, while others use generalized algebraic data types to leverage the type system of the host language. Our tagless final representation, however, neither uses tags to handle type information, nor does it represent programs using algebraic data types. Instead, we use the actual OCaml program to represent itself, but we parameterize it over an arbitrary interpretation using a functor. A central concept of AD-OCaml is the algebra within which a user program is interpreted. Here is a simplified example. If the signature of an algebra overflows, besides some mathematical operations, it provides for a function that lifts standard machine floats into that algebra. Here, we instantiate the standard algebra where the abstract float is just a standard float. Now we define an example program that is parameterized over an arbitrary algebra. If we instantiate this example program using the standard algebra, we obtain an evaluator for the program over standard floats. That may seem like a lot of hoops to jump through just to evaluate a simple program, but the next slide will show you how powerful the tagless final representation really is. On this slide, we implement forward mode algorithmic differentiation by transforming algebras, by transforming interpreters of our program. We want to augment them with directional derivatives using the chain rule of calculus. This will allow us to obtain the exact directional derivative of our whole program with respect to its input. First, as a reminder, here is our example problem and the chain rule of calculus as applied to it. We now implement the functor makeDual, which transforms an arbitrary base algebra such that we can keep track of values and the derivatives with respect to the function input. For example, the sine function will calculate the sine in the base algebra and also its derivative, the cosine, which is then multiplied with the derivative of its argument with respect to the program input. This way, forward mode evaluates a chain rule from right to left. We now instantiate the makeDual functor with the standard algebra and our example program with the augmented dual algebra. Then we evaluate the program with the augmented input to obtain both the function value and its exact derivative in one fell swoop. The user program did not require any modification whatsoever. As you can see, the function argument is also augmented with the rightmost part of our chain rule here, dx over dx, which is just 1. Using functors for calculating derivatives is admittedly less easy on the eyes than using functions, as other frameworks like AL or DiffSharp chose to do. But unless you only want to implement small functions, or in the unlikely case that you need to calculate derivatives all over the place in your program, this fixed syntactic overhead is insubstantial and comes with significant advantages. On this slide, you can see a trace of the computations performed by our example program in forward mode. Here's the input, and here we have the function value and its derivative. Forward mode AD with dual numbers is easy to implement and has comparatively low bookkeeping requirements. Sadly, it is only efficient if there are a few inputs to a program. In practice, this is often the less interesting application case. If you have millions or even billions of parameters, it is infeasible to calculate gradients one by one using forward mode. Reverse mode AD, which we will show on the next slide, can address this efficiently. Furthermore, each time we take derivatives by nesting dual algebras with the makeDual functor, the computational effort grows exponentially for obtaining higher order derivatives. That's why AD-OCaml implements forward mode using a UTP functor. This functor generates algebras over univariate Taylor polynomials. These are essentially truncated power series. AD-OCaml uses convolution algorithms on UTPs that run in quadratic time to obtain high-order power series approximations of programs. If you have only a few, or as is most often the case, one output, the result of a loss function for example, but large numbers of inputs, then reverse mode AD will allow us to handle the user program efficiently, at least in terms of computation time, because unfortunately reverse mode requires tracing all operations and intermediate results for your program in order to work. This can cause problems with memory consumption. Reverse mode AD benefits from introducing the concept of an adjoint. The adjoint of a value is simply the derivative of the whole program with respect to that value. It will be propagated from the end of the program through all intermediate values to the beginning to calculate the complete gradient in one go. A seemingly innocuous observation is that values can be used more than once within a program. As a consequence, we actually have to add up adjoint contributions from all the users. This makes adjoint calculations intrinsically imperative in nature, with huge consequences for frameworks that were not designed right off the bat with support for imperative functions in mind. This is probably the single most important oversight in the vast majority of frameworks out there, including, but not limited to the AL framework. Even purely functional user programs may not work correctly or efficiently because reverse mode inverts the flow of your program and turns reads into writes. This may force you to copy large amounts of data on even tiny reads, which can decrease performance without bounds, or force you to abandon support for such completely ordinary and frequently used operations entirely. It would basically prohibit support for aliasing, for example, sharing a column of a matrix as a vector. AD-OCaml has unrestricted support for imperative updates, including in-place operations, which, for example, PyTorch and AutoGrad do not support. It can thus handle a greater number of user programs correctly and efficiently. Here is a computational graph of our example calculated using reverse mode. As mentioned earlier, reverse mode is great for handling programs that have large numbers of inputs, but memory consumption can be a problem. It is also fairly difficult to implement correctly, especially if you want to support imperative updates, aliasing, or extensibility. A nice side effect of reverse mode is that it requires accurate tracing of programs. The resulting trace is useful for many purposes, for example, reusing previously allocated values, which can give a quite noticeable performance boost, or for visualizations and symbolic optimizations. There are some limitations when it comes to AD. Not all programs whose derivatives exist are written in a way that works with AD. The function on this slide computes the square of x in a rather unusual way. The problem here is that when x is 3, then AD would believe it has to return a constant, whose derivative is 0, which is clearly incorrect. The solution is for users to never let the control flow of their programs depend on values in whose derivatives they are interested. Typical user programs can frequently be fixed to avoid this. Complicated cases, for example, numerically stable matrix factorization algorithms, can often be handled by extending algebras with new operators. Certain operations are inherently non-differentiable for certain inputs. For example, taking the maximum of two numbers, which leads to kinky user programs. Such kinks in the function can typically be smoothed out, and AD-OCaml provides support for that. Since it can also calculate directional derivatives, and not just gradients, it can handle some cases that reverse mode cannot. We could also handle such situations by raising exceptions if some value is too close for comfort to a singularity. There is a lot of competition among frameworks out there, but in my experience, most frameworks have significant shortcomings. Some may only support explicitly constructed computational graphs, for example like TensorFlow. This is infeasible for some real-world programs. Some cut corners when it comes to how general user programs can be, or break scalability in seemingly normal use cases. Some, especially ones implemented in Python, are atrociously slow when it comes to handling individual floats, often hundreds, if not thousands of times slower. Or they may bomb on programs with deep computational graphs, as I've seen with TensorFlow and OCaml. AD-OCaml has been very carefully designed to work correctly and efficiently on even the largest and most complicated OCaml programs to which AD can be applied at all. It also mostly eliminates any cognitive overhead required for parallelizing them. Let's discuss the current state of AD-OCaml. Thanks to a rigorous test suite with about 5,000 lines of code, AD-OCaml, which has close to 50,000 lines of code, has reached maturity for production applications. It features almost all float operations provided in the C99 standard, which also work on vectors and matrices. It is mostly compatible with OCaml. Many BLAS and LAPACK operations are supported, including Kolesky and QR factorizations, symmetric eigenproblems, and triangular matrix operations. Aliasing of vectors and matrices is fully supported. UTP and reverse mode, as well as function tracers, can be mixed without restrictions. Traced user programs can reuse previously allocated values like matrices. This can greatly improve efficiency when reruns are needed, for example with iterative optimizers. Implicit parallelism works transparently through all nesting levels. It can be used directly on user programs without having to generate a full computational graph first. AD-OCaml achieves this by creating and reducing partial computational graphs in parallel, on the fly. User programs that are instantiated with the standard algebra will evaluate exactly as expected and can thus be run essentially without any significant dependencies on the framework. One big feature still missing right now is support for GPUs, for which OCaml is unfortunately lacking dependable libraries at the moment. It may not be difficult to add this to AD-OCaml, since derivative calculations are oblivious to the underlying type of value. To show off the capabilities of this system, let me present you with one of the test suites in the framework. It applies AD to approximately 1,100 lines of numerical code. Due to its testing of corner cases, it is considerably more complicated than what most users would write. Here you have a functor that parameterizes a program over an algebra. And as you can see from a quick scroll through the program, it is exceptionally complicated. Due to its testing of corner cases, it's considerably more complicated than what most users would write. It maps one input to one output, which allows us to compare the results of both forward and reverse modes directly for correctness and performance. Bumping is used too for verification and to show the substantial difference in accuracy and efficiency. Finally, both the standard and the parallel algebra demonstrate the correctness and performance of implicit parallelism. Please note that this test suite was absolutely not written with benchmarking parallelism in mind. In fact, it deliberately creates a narrow and deep computational graph to improve detection of errors in reverse mode. This greatly reduces opportunities for parallelism. The parallel algebra, nevertheless, still finds ample opportunities for improving performance. The resulting derivatives of our program show that both UTP and reverse modes achieve greater accuracy than bumping. Note that the test suite was deliberately written to make bumping work well for verification. Bumping less well-behaved programs with less well-tuned epsilons can lead to meaningless results. It is sometimes impossible to obtain sufficient accuracy with bumping, even with tuning. Let's discuss the timing results. There are lies, damn lies, and then there are benchmarks. This is not a benchmark. It is a test suite for correctness, and as such not tuned to make AD-OCaml look fast. In fact, its deliberately narrow and deep computational graph only offers few opportunities for parallelism, which the parallel algebra is happy to exploit. The test suite is evaluated twice on slightly different inputs to show the impact of rerunning program traces. This shows that, shockingly, rerunning the trace of your OCaml program makes it faster than the original with the standard algebra. In fact, traced programs are hard to beat for most purposes. The test also shows that implicit parallelism, at least on this program, improves everything. It is interesting to note that evaluating the program and calculating its derivatives in parallel is only marginally slower than running the plain vanilla user program with the standard algebra. I hope this is a pretty convincing argument for AD-OCaml and the tagless final style, which makes combining program transformations so much easier. Thanks for your attention.